65 meant the end of work and the start of retirement. But now, thousands of older Australians are forced to stay in the workforce longer and longer, and thousands more are choosing to.
He's now into his fifth decade of business, and Tony Arena isn't going anywhere anytime soon.
I'm keen to stay on and keep a challenge in my life, have a diverse range of interests. One of them includes working for a living. And the word retirement doesn't really come into it.
It's a similar story for his 78-year-old employee, Jerry Elkin, and a growing number of Australians. A decade ago, only 10% of the country's workforce was over 65. It's now jumped to almost 15%. And one in three of those older workers live here in New South Wales, with 182,000 people across the state working well into their traditional retirement years.
It's grown massively. These are record numbers, and we will continue to see this number rise.
The main reason, we're all living longer.
So a 65-year-old today can expect to live another 21 years.
And the longer we live, the longer we spend, extending careers to cover the cost of travel, busier lifestyles, and often medical costs, and to top up super funds gouged by the GFC. Others choose to keep working to stay engaged and contribute. And for many, including DJ Philip Muscatello, it's a combination of both.
I don't have enough money to retire at the moment, but it's also because I enjoy the work that I do.
The data also shows older Australians aren't just doing a few hours here and there. Almost half are still working full time.
They offer that experience, that expertise, that mentoring to the next generation. They've got that knowledge that they bring, and they make a great positive contribution to the economy as well.
And as 75 becomes the new 65, the R word may one day become a thing of the past. Alice Monfries, Nine News.
That's a lot of years ahead, Mike.
Too many.